Hey guys, it's Mike here again, One Go Short Play. And we finally reached Games in English, which is cool, on the Mega Drive. This is Real Monsters, or something like that. Based on the popular cartoon of the what mid-90s? Early mid-90s. See what I'm gonna do while I'm here. While I'm on camera, very unprofessionally, I'm gonna open that volume mixer. And I'm going to crank the game volume a bit because the games have been a bit quiet, I think. Hopefully, that is not making noise over me. We'll find out. Right, let's play. Somehow. Oh, I see. It's because I clicked off the window. There we go. That's better. Oh, that's cool. Look at that. I like that. Let's see. Oh, let's see the options. Now we're here. Scary. Definitely scary. Oh, nightmare. Oh, I see. That's difficulty. Let's keep it scary. Nice little animation there. Okay, I'm happy with that. Scare, throw, jump, whatevs. We can work that out. Go, let's go, little monsters. Good morning. It's time for you to feature in a platform game. Ah, I think we've got some kind of exposition here. Oh, I see, okay. Today, your lesson is to find a shoe. Gotcha. No idea why we're doing that. I think that's just the lesson. It's best not to ask. Okay, so I'm controlling. Now, I don't know the names of these little characters. I remember the cartoon. I didn't really watch it. I'm controlling the little pink dude. Whoa! And the other dudes are following him. That was quite scary. Yeah, that's pretty cool. He doesn't scare that little maggot. That maggot's not afraid of anything. Okay, so we jump. Whoa! Oh, come on! Okay, right, so we gotta watch out for stuff like that. I'm just throwing junk. I'm throwing junk around the place. Alright, that looks spiky, but it's got something by it. Oh, no, the thing that's by it is the thing that's telling me it's spiky. Cockroach. Ah, oh, yeah. Little monkey mouse. Right. Okay, it's a platformer. I played this before, and an emulation. Those little spikes are making me want to pick them up because they're sparkling. I played this before in emulation years ago, and I have to admit, I didn't really get into it that much. I think, again, it felt a little bit sort of scrappy, the way the scrolling's a little bit too loose, and for my liking. And I think I got bored before I started figuring out the puzzle elements. Like, I think those things I was just stood on. Let's go back to it. That. I think maybe razors or something, and then you get up there. I want to select the other two guys, and I can't. All I can do is scare, throw, and jump. Oh, wait, pause. And pause. That's about it. Okay, we're not going that... Oh, we are going that way. I thought we were going back. Oh, go on then, let's go up here. So, I'm guessing we're picking up these rather pretty Art Deco lamps. Oh, rather pretty but broken Art Deco lamps. Not quite sure why they are of particular value and why they are in such abundance down here. But hey, have some of that. But hey, the game allows us to pick them up, so we'll pick them up. Now, I can't... Ah, I was going to say, I can't influence that by just walking into it. Well, get out from under that. Oh, you silly, stripey person. No. Go up there. But you can't jump. There's something that I'm missing here. As I say, I think back in the day, I got a bit bored before I started sussing stuff like that. Oh, man. Yeah, and that loose scrolling... Oh, it gets on me wick a bit, I have to admit. I prefer it to be a bit tighter than that. But hey. It's not really a biggie, is it? Oh, I recognise this place. But I'm bored of that place. I'm going this way. No, I'm going this way. Oh, you little monkey thing again. It's not a monkey at all. See, that was a bit... A bit off. Oh, right. I don't think there's anything down there, is there? Let's go back. It is this way. I know it's this way. The game's telling me it's this way. Look, there it is telling me. It's this way. Ooh, hello, Mr. One Up. Which is probably really hard to get without some kind of portable trampoline. Oh, if only you're a trampoline. I can drag you over there. You are a trampoline. Actually, that's a point. No, they're not portable. Right, I'm going this way. I know it says go that way. But there's stuff here. Look, there's that here. That's stuff. I want that. Why can't I jump and get it? Why can't I jump high enough for this game? Have I got to pick something up that lets me jump higher? This game's probably ace if you have a bit of patience. I have no patience. I think if I was a kid and I'd spent 40 quid, well, 20 quid, I think by the time I could afford it on a game like this, on this game, which I would never have done because I'd have bought, there's loads of other games I'd have bought before this and I probably wouldn't have spent even 20 quid on them. I'd have found ways to get them cheaper. But if I had spent, was a kid and I'd spent money on this game, I would obviously invest the time to work it out. You have to get up there, but there's no clue as to how you do it. And this is exactly what happened last time I played this. I got about here and I was just like, oh, I'm sick of it. Now, really, were I a more intelligent game player, I would be seeing signs all over the place that tell me what I need to get through that particular section of the game. And it's all down to just not being able to jump high enough. I'm going to try and figure this out in the 10 minutes. And I'll be really disappointed if it's something stupid and obvious. So they're spiky. That arrow says go that way, but I think, ooh, that tyre makes you jump. But why? Why does that tyre let you jump? There's no reason, because you can jump up there without it. Is it just a demo that tyres let you jump? Okay, well, maybe that's something I'm missing. Maybe there's a tyre up there. We'll have a look next time we find ourselves wandering up there. If we can't find anything down here that opens it. I'm sure you should be able to swap between characters. Now, you can't go that way. That's the beginning of the level. There we go. We've seen it all up to the point that we can't get past. Oh, did I just run? Oh. All right, okay. It killed me and put me back. Did I just run, though? I think I ran a bit faster. Wasn't a double tap. It wasn't that. Although I did enjoy doing it. Right, that gets that. Can I use that? Buzz. Bear in mind the Mega Drive's only got three buttons. Ah, hello. Oh, hello! Character select. You hold down an A. Okay, what the little eyeball do there? Oh, they've all got limited jumps. What's your scare? Whoa! That's cool. What's your scare? I like your tongues. Again? Oh, you've got to charge it up or something. Okay. I'm going to use the stripey dude. I like him. Oh, hair. It's a hair, isn't it? Now, if I hold down an A, it does that. What if I hold down a B? Oh, it does that. What if I hold down a C? What if I hold up and C? Am I being really stupid? Up and C. No. No, we're pretty stuck. Maybe this character can interact with other things. You know, it's worth a crack. Ooh. More of those weird little lamps. See, I picked up like loads of books before. I had like a number of books. Those M books at the top. I'm picking up all this stuff. It's not even points, I don't know what it is. I pause and do the buttons. Nah. It's gonna take a bit of figuring out, I guess. I want that. Give me that. Oh, maybe it is just a really, really tight jump. But hey, we're never gonna know because time's up. That was Aaahh! Real Monsters on the Sega Mega Drive. Thank you very much for watching. See you next time.